Are you all students? This is your science class and we have started lesson number 3, fiber to fabric. And up to now we have completed that what is the role of cloth in our life. The primary purpose of cloth is to cover our body and to protect ourselves from extreme cold, heat, rain and snow. As you all know that clothes are made up from fabric, and beside clothing we also use fabric to make bed sheets, curtain, cushion covers, your upholstery, all this. And even in our kitchen we are using mops, duster, which are also made up of fabric. So you can say that in everyday life we are facing different uses of fabric. And in this chapter we are going to read different type of fibers, their sources and how these fibers are changed into fabric. So if we see the early man, he used to protect himself from natural elements like heat, cold, rain, and he used to cover his body with the help of animal skin, fur, leaves, grass, bark of tree or even bones and shells. And afterward, when the agriculture community started, when the person start progressing, then he started weaving Twigs means, in Hindi we can say tahni, and grasses into long strands. Strands means a long zigzag woven thing, we can say. So after that, slowly and slowly they begin to weave this strand into cloth or fibers. Okay, then what happened? When these people know or learned the simple needles out of this animal bones, they started sewing. And with the revolution of wheel and different industrial revolution also start, and the all clothes were sewn. Okay, so by and by the person, the human being know how to weave the cloth, how they can be made in factories, and different type of there are varieties of texture of clothes we found around us due to this revolution only. Then type of fabric. Students, we are using different type of cloth at our home. Some if we are in summer season, then we used to wear such type of cloth which give us cool effect and which did not absorb heat. And we know that the fabric protect us from cold, heat, rain and dust. Then according to the seasons we used to wear clothes, and these different type of clothes are made up of different type of fabrics. So let us perform the following activity to learn about it. In this activity 1, what we have done, we have taken a cotton cloth and cut any two opposite side of the cotton cloth with the help of scissor. And if we took some loose thread out of it and pull a loose thread out, this is called yarn. And this fiber, or we can say this fabric, is made up of large number of such yarns are woven together. Okay, so in this, what we call, we got a yarn is made up of many thin strand, and each of these strand of yarn is made up of still thinner strands called fabric. Okay, so let us do the next topic, that is sources of fiber. From where we are getting this fiber? You know that every fabric is made up from fiber. Okay, so from where we are getting it? We are obtaining it from plants as well as animal, and some are made up of made by our self also. So the fibers which we are getting from nature, they are called natural fibers. Okay, like from plants and animals we are getting, and the fibers which we are not getting from natural sources, which are made by man, they are called synthetic fiber, like nylon, polyester, terricot, teflon, terylene. All these are the example of man-made or synthetic fiber. I repeat it once again that each fabric is made up of fibers, and we have two type of fibers. First one is natural fiber, which is obtained from animals, okay, and plants. Such are called natural fibers. Fibers that are extracted from plants and animal are known as natural fibers, like cotton, jute, silk, wool are example of natural fiber. And if we see plant fibers, they are classified into following type, like fruit fibers, like this cotton and coconut fibers are the example of fruit fibers. These fibers are obtained from the fruits of the plant. Then bast fiber, BAST. These fibers are obtained from the stem of the plant. They are generally very long, like jute and hemp are the example of bast fiber. Then leaf fibers, the fibers which are obtained from the leaves are rough and sturdy, like sisal fibers are explained from examples of leaf fibers. These sisal fibers are very hard, cold, strong and moisture resistant. Therefore, they are used for making rope, net, carpet and handicraft work. Okay, so you have done today the plant fiber, and the fourth one is stalk fiber. These type of fibers are getting from stalk of the plant, like straw of wheat, rice and barley are the example of stalk fibers. Then seed fibers. These fibers are collected from seeds or seed case. Cotton and kapoke are the example of seed fiber. Okay, so I think you in this video you have learned that what are the importance of cloth, what are fiber, what are fabric, and natural fiber we have completed. Students, in our next video we are going to do regarding cotton. So till then you revise the topic that how many type of natural fibers we are having. We are having 5 type of natural fiber. The first one is fruit fiber, then bast fiber, leaf fiber and stalk fiber, and the last one is seed fiber. And in our next video we are going to complete our cotton and other fibers one by one. So till then, thank you, have a nice day.